the most secure app for end-to-end encrypted, privacy-oriented communication. And that's Signal. A lot of people are looking for a good privacy app with all the confusion out there about some of the other companies, whether or not they are actually doing encryption, how they're actually handling your data, or sometimes mishandling that data. So we're going to dive into the Signal app and why it's my favorite app for secure communications. A couple things I want to get right out of the way when it comes to Signal. One, a lot of people have issue with the fact that it uses a phone number for identity. But don't worry, there's an easy workaround. Find any voice service, and I've reviewed VoIPMS, which does support text services where you can buy a phone number, and you can use Signal on a brand new phone number you buy from somewhere like VoIPMS for a few dollars a month. So that way you can use Signal on a device without having it tied to your personal phone number. But I like it tied to my personal phone number for talking to all of my friends, and, you know, makes it an easy way to do it. Next, I will address the other issues. And one of those bigger ones is, well, there's other companies that are open source, Tom, there's other platforms, and et cetera, that are also open source, that are also, even some of them use, because the Signal algorithm and all the technology behind it is open source and other companies do integrate it into their platforms. Signal has a couple distinct differences from those other companies. One of them is it's not a company, it's an organization. This is a very important distinction when you're looking for a application, because what's their business model? How are they going to leverage privacy or not? And that sometimes comes in the case of their business model is harvesting some type of data about you, charging you for the app, or selling off the company because they have a business that's set up to run for free, to build up users. And once they run out of venture capital money, they're hoping to sell to someone else. None of those issues affect Signal. And because they set up as an organization, not just a group of people working on an open source project, which of course is another distinction, this means the organization can continue and keep allowing a free application. Plus, the bylaws of the organization, well, it doesn't have a methodology by which it can sell its users' data. They also chose not to have users' data. Signal has been really vetted by some really familiar names in security, such as Bruce Schneier, Jack Dorsey's used Signal, Edward Snowden, Moxie Marlinspike's the original author of the Signal protocol and everything else. Very privacy-oriented. Now, let's get over to features. This is where things get really cool. Share without insecurity, state-of-the-art end-to-end encryption. This is an important thing that they have this, because a lot of companies claim end-to-end encryption, but when you dig into it, they're the key holder. Like, oh, we use end-to-end encryption, but we also hold a copy of the keys. So this is where it becomes a buzzword versus a practical security measure. They don't hold the keys. The encryption starts on the device, it, from where you are initiating the phone call, the text message or multimedia message, whatever you're sending, or video call like I did at the beginning of the video, and it ends encrypted on wherever it lands the other place. At no point in between does Signal hold your keys. So while other companies claim end-to-end encryption, they're also wanting to do the key management, and key management means they have the potential for subpoena or anyone else to tap into that either. Let's get to features though. Say anything, speak freely. They get all the cool things that you want out of a messaging app. Make privacy stick. A new layer of expression in your conversations, encrypted stickers. It's kind of fun, like the standard things you may want out of a messaging app, because it doesn't have to be just, you know, some type of basic boring text, but all well encrypted. No, let's put some stickers and have some fun, but also why not encrypt all of that? Get together with groups. This is another feature they've added. It's really great. Now, one of my challenges I've always had is I didn't like when you have people on Android platform or the Apple platform and their messaging app and getting groups together. Yeah, there was always some challenges. If I didn't see the message, it doesn't show this attach. Signal, because it's completely cross-platform, works on Android, works on Apple, works on Linux, works on Mac, works on Windows. So my group conversation that I started on any one device, I can move to another device and carry over that group conversation with me and join in those conversations, and it doesn't matter. And like I said, I have a lot of friends using this that work in security, and I've even got a lot of my family using this. So this is my preferred methodology for communicating, and it's actually been really convenient. Last thing I'll mention is I love the fact that you can set ephemeral messaging on there, because most of the messages I have, most of them are really mundane, but that does not mean I need a complete long archive of them. And Signal makes it really easy to set expiring messages. You can say only hold messages in this group chat for 24 hours, 2 hours, whatever that may be. So if you do have to send something very private or secure, maybe some type of password or some piece of information, like, you know, I recently bought a house and I had to exchange information to my wife and I don't want to just send personal documents that I needed to do the home purchase, I have no trouble at all. One, sending them through Signal means I was able to quickly get her some piece of information privately, securely, no worries about people seeing it. And it had an expiration time on it. I set it to an hour. She only needed it of that moment. So within an hour, it just disappears off the phone. And now it's gone without a trace in case I ever, you know, forget the phone somewhere or someone unlocks it. Having that long history, Signal makes it a lot easier to do. Link to signal.org. There's no other thing I have. There's no offer because it's free and it's just something I really endorse. And by the way, if you're really curious to dive into the encryption deeper, that's all documented as well with all their source code, and they have the entire methodologies by which they encrypt things. So if you're really into that, trust me, they've got it all documented, and it's kind of a fun read if you're into cryptography. And it has been vetted, as I said, by people like Bruce Schneier, who also is really into cryptography and took the time to actually audit and vet the code. All right, thanks. Thank you.